Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you the haul that I did for Polish Pickup July Rewind Month of 2023. I was doing so good not buying Polish Pickup, but July got to me. It got to me good, which is very surprising. This year, since I wasn't buying at all, I thought for sure I am not gonna need anything in July. And that proved to be a lie. So I'm going to share with you all the polishes and products that I purchased for July. So I'm going to start off with the products that I purchased. One of the first one is the KB Shimmer Sugar Scrub in Oatmeal, Milk, and Honey. Now this is, I think this was coming back, right? Everything came back, right? So the one that I do have now is a fall-inspired, like, pumpkin-y scent, and I am, like, up to here maybe. It lasts me a while. A little goes a long way. I don't need it for every manicure. Like, I did use it today and I feel like you can tell that my hands look, I don't know, they just feel smoother, softer. All of the excess skin is gone. I honestly like it a little bit better for my body. Like, I have used it for, like, pre-shaving to do a full body scrub in the shower. I actually enjoyed this one because it is kind of coarse. There are other brands that I enjoy because they're a little bit more emollient. Is that the right word? Like, they're softer but still remove the layers that sugar scrubs are supposed to remove. But I still really enjoy it, and the price is amazing, and the scents from KB Shimmer are amazing. Now, this I actually forgot that I purchased in the month of July. This is Unicorn Magic in Lemon Cotton Candy Deluxe Cuticle Rescue. I actually talked about wanting to purchase this exact same product for August Polish Pickup because, one, I like the scents that are being offered, and two, I'm running out of the one that I already have. And then, I kid you not, I did my August wish list video on Monday. Today is Wednesday. I received this and I was like, oh, I forgot. I forgot that I purchased this in July. So I'm actually really happy that I have this. And this, oh my God, I love this. This a little goes a long way. I don't think I was on in camera, but I feel like it melts really fast and it doesn't leave you feeling oily and greasy. And I'm just really, really happy that I have this. And the last non-polish item that I'm gonna share with you all is Baroness X Acetone Antidote. Holy cow, this bottle is so big. I have not purchased a Baroness X Acetone Antidote in a really long time, and the last time I purchased this brand or this product, the bottle was like this little. Look at that, like, that's a big difference. I'm getting a lot of product. I really love this. I've tried other brands. I actually have a sweet and sour lacquer, and this one's almost out. I'm about to refill my 8-ounce acetone bottle that I use with acetone antidote, and I'm gonna use this up. And so now I'm glad that I have a backup, but I haven't purchased from this brand in a really long time. I really, really enjoy this brand. There are scents from Polish Pickup that I wish would return. Honestly, I'm gonna email the maker and maybe see if make those scents again, just so that I can have them because I love them so much. This is called Wild Passion Fruit, and I absolutely love passion fruit and passion fruit scents as well. And so I'm really excited to use this as soon as I use this one up, which this one was coconut and blue agave from Sweet and Sour Lacquer, which I really did enjoy. But I felt like since I haven't used this brand in so long, I wanted to try it again, and I really enjoy the smell. I did not realize how big this bottle would be, but I'm very glad that I purchased this. And for Rewind Month, I actually had a color scheme of, apparently. I was very into getting the greens that I had missed out the first time around. Now this is Polished for Days in Jack-O-Lantern, and I actually have this already. I bought this as a backup. Yeah, I know. I have way too many polishes to be worried about purchasing backups, but I really like this polish a lot, especially for Halloween, or for not even just Halloween, but for the fall season. And I wanted it. I mean, I don't feel like I have to justify it. I wanted to have a backup of it, and I'm glad that I have it. But because this is a backup, I don't want to open the bottle, so I am going to pull out my open and used bottle to swatch for everyone to see. So normally I have my nails painted, so I usually use a swatch wheel for my swatching of my polish pickup hauls. However, because my nails are not painted, I decided to paint on my bare nails. I think I'm gonna put a base coat on and then put the polish on. So the first polish that I'm going to show is the Polish for Days. And like I said before, this is the Jack-O-Lantern. This is the original back from September of 2021. So that's just one coat of Polish for Days Jack-O-Lantern. And I wanted you to see it a little bit more up close. And yeah, I really love how this looks. This is just one coat, so obviously it's still pretty sheer. But I like all of the components that are in here, especially these little micro, I don't want to say microscopic, but really teeny tiny micro flakes, black flakes that are in here, or black glitters. I don't know, I can't quite tell what shape they are. They look kind of irregular. So we're gonna go with that. This is a perfect Halloween polish, in my personal opinion. So that's why I wanted a backup. Next we have Dreamland Lacquer in Shake Your Shamrock. I don't know why I skipped this the first time, but I remember that everybody loved this color. This is one of those polishes that were really hyped up after the fact, and I was like, man, I really want to get that. So it wasn't my number one pick for the month of Rewind, but it was definitely like up there on my radar. I had a really big list for the entire month. So here we go with the Dreamland Lacquer. Oh, this is like creamy, but like, I don't know, something. I have to be careful. I have to float it a little bit. Wow, look at that glow. I mean, that looks insane. So that is an insane glow for that blue shimmer. I feel like you have to be careful with your brush application. It's definitely one of those polishes that I think will obviously leave some dragging on the bottom layer. Like the second time you put this on, if it's not completely dry, it might drag the bottom layer a little bit. And it is drying a little matte. It looks kind of matte. So maybe, I don't know, this is like an insanely bright polish. But the first coat doesn't look as pretty as it does in the bottle. So I can't wait to get the second coat on. Next we have Bluebird Lacquers in Rock of Sages. And this is a polish that I remember liking a lot when it came out, and then kind of like meh about it when it actually came time. Seeing it on my feed, I was like, why did I skip out on this? Particularly recently, I saw it on Polish with Ray when she did the collaboration for my birthday this year, which I really appreciated, but it like reminded me, oh yeah, I really like that polish. I really wanted that polish. But you know, I don't know. Sometimes I feel like when the spoilers come out, some polishes like grab my attention right away and I'm like, oh my gosh, yes, I have to get it. And then, I don't know, I don't want to say I forget about them, but you know, other polishes take their place and they get moved down the list. And so I end up like missing out on some really, really pretty polishes. Well, that application was a dream. That is beautiful. It's so sparkly. So pretty. This is a really pretty polish. And then the final polish that I purchased for Polish Pickup Rewind in July was Atomic Polish in Sour Apple Rings. This was another one that I really, really regretted not picking up. And I didn't pick it up because I have a J. Ren polish that I felt was very similar to it, Radioactive Num Num, and I love that polish. Even though I no longer support that brand, I really do love that polish. But I wanted to have something that looked very similar to it that I could support and be happy that I purchased. And holy smokes, is this bright. Oh my goodness. This is like ridiculously bright.
This is really bright
and a lot yellower of that first coat than I was expecting. So I'm going to let this dry a little bit more and then do each one with a second coat.
All right. So here we have two coats of all the polishes and a top coat.
So the first one, like I said before, is the Jack-O-Lantern from Polish for Days. I personally like this better at three coats. I think it deepens the color a little bit. It also gives, I like flakies at three coats. I do. I also prefer to put a ridge filling.
I also enjoy putting like a glitter grabber kind of top coat before I put the quick dry top coat on, or a smoothing top coat. I don't know what they're called. I just call it glitter grabber because that's the first one I used and that's why I call all of them.
But I know that's from Glisten Glow. But if you have any kind of smoothing top coat, that would work really well. Personally, I feel like it gives this super glossy, super resin kind of look to the nails, especially for flaky bombs like this. That's the way I would wear it. That's the way I like to wear them. And I do prefer this one at three coats. But as you can see, two coats is completely opaque. I didn't have like a blurring base coat underneath. I mean, I have nothing but good things about Polish to say about Polish for Days. It was one of my first favorite indie brands. It's still one of my favorite indie brands. I'm usually satisfied with anything that I purchase from them. Very rarely will I be unsatisfied with something, and that's usually more for personal taste. Next, we have the Dreamland Lacquer, and this is Shake Your Shamrock. And yeah, this lives up to the hype for sure. On camera, you're seeing definitely a lot more of the blue shimmer. In real life, I feel like, yes, I can definitely see the blue shimmer, but it kind of gives this aura where the blue shimmer is more, I don't know, like around the edges here. And then I see a lot of the green. This is going to be super shifty. This is one of those polishes that is going to look different in different lighting at different times of the day. I love polishes like that. So yeah, super happy with this one as well. Do not regret it and definitely worth the hype. Next, we have the Bluebird Lacquer, and this is Rock of Sages. And this is lovely, quite beautifully stunning. But this one, I feel once I applied it, I feel like I have something like it. I'm not thinking Merida because the color base is all wrong, but it's very, I mean, it's similar to like Zoya Merida vibes, but like, I don't know, brighter, more like fresh. I feel Merida's definitely very dark, very green, as in like kind of like an evergreen color. This one feels more, I don't know, emeraldy. I love this. This is beautiful, but I do feel like, I don't know, this one is kind of a, I love it, but I feel like I have something like it. And so it's making me feel like, should I have bought this or should I have gotten something else that was on my list? But it is quite lovely. And the formula from Bluebird Lacquer is fantastic. I'm going to have to actually wear this to give my like final judgment on this polish, but I do like it. It is lovely. It's just, I don't know if I really needed it. And then finally we have Atomic Polish, and this is Sour Apple Rings. Oh, this is amazing. I'm so happy that I'm able to put this video together because I want to wear this before the end of this summer season. So I think this is the polish that I'm going to wear. I'm going to take all of these off and wear this on all my nails because it is amazing and I love it. So this one was definitely like the, I love them all, but this one, this one is like the top winner for me for this month of polishes.
So I'm gonna cut what I was talking about before. I forgot to mention this. This actually came in today. This is Rogue Lacquer, a little dark and a little gloomy, and it is from Polish Pickup Rewind Month. I don't remember when this came out. This polish, oh my gosh, it is beyond so pretty. I absolutely love this polish, and I don't remember when it came out the original time, but I remember seeing it later and was thinking, oh my gosh, why didn't I get it? And now looking at it in person, I realized I didn't get it because it probably reminded me of Wildflower Lacquer's blue flaky polish. However, I forgot about that polish when July came around. So I purchased the Rogue, and since it came in today and I literally had my husband check the mail before I finished this video, we're gonna swatch this on my thumb. All right, so this is my thumb and this is the first swatch. I'm pretty sure, oh wow, this looks lovely. I'm pretty sure that this will be, oh yeah. This, oh, that's just a big old mess. Okay. So this is definitely not the same as that, similar enough, but not the same as that Wildflower Lacquer that I was thinking of, whose name is literally like escaping me right now. So yeah, so this polish is awesome. That first coat covers really well, considering. But I'm gonna do a second coat, and I'm not gonna do a third coat just for swatching purposes, but in real life, I probably would. I'm just gonna be honest. I usually do it with flaky bombs like this. All right, so here we have two coats of A Little Dark, A Little Gloomy. Now, I did not put the top coat on because I am running out of time to film this video and then paint my nails. And so it is gorgeous. This is like, I'm very happy that I purchased this. I have no regrets about purchasing this one. It is quite lovely. So here we have all five polishes that I purchased for the month of July, rewind month for polish pickup. Super excited with all of them. The Atomic polish is definitely my favorite. This is a backup, so I mean, does it really count? I think it shouldn't count. So these four are the ones that really should count. This is my favorite, this is my second favorite, this is my third favorite, and I feel like Bluebird Lacquer is like my fourth favorite. Not that I don't like it, but I do feel like I have something like it, and these I feel like were a lot more unique. This one, even though I feel like it did at first remind me of that Wildflower Lacquer, whose name I can't remember, inspired by Titanic, My Heart Will Go On, that stone. Gosh, what is wrong with me today? I can't think of, like, words are hard. But yeah, it reminded me of it at first, but honestly, it's not that, I mean, it's similar that I probably don't need both, but there are differences to this. There are black shards here, and I feel like there's reflective glitters in this one. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I feel like there's some reflective glitters. But yeah. All in all, not a bad haul. Kind of wish I would have gotten a different one just because, again, it just reminds me of something I already have. But other than that, I love everything that I got, especially the other non-polished products. Let me know in the comments down below if you purchased any of these polishes and which one was your favorite. If you did, thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.